guys, Remy here, welcome back to another video. Today is more of a catch-up video because I've had like a really busy time lately. I've barely had any spare time to myself, but thankfully I have been able to pick up a couple of records in the rare moments I have been able to just chill out. So I really want to show you what I've got. Starting off with Daydreams and Nightmares by Those Dancing Days. I found this album on Discogs and I had to buy it at that moment because if I didn't buy it there and then, I would have never seen it again. I was rhymed, but okay. Those Dancing Days were an indie pop band from Sweden. They were mostly making music in the mid-2000s and broke up in the early 2010s. This is their second and final album. And I'm really sad that they broke up because they had such a short span and I would have loved to have heard more of their music. But this album is very much like typical electronic indie pop from the early 2010s, so it's quite nostalgic to me. This album came out in 2011, however I didn't discover it till 2013, so every time I hear the songs from this album I get instantly taken back to when I was a very young teenager, and it just makes me very happy. The first track, Reaching Forward, you know, it's got like this like searing kind of keyboard at the beginning, and then these amazing drums kick in. Like the drummer, I think her name is Cece, I don't know, I'm gonna butcher it, but there's a photo of the band. She is incredible. She's probably the best drummer I've ever had the pleasure of listening to. Like, she's mental, she's mad. Like, the songs have like this rampant urgency that are just incredible. I'm just like, whoa, and I don't get tired of it and I don't stop being mesmerized by that drumming. And then the keyboard throughout this whole album, which is done by Lisa, is just incredible. And then, I hope I'm pronouncing her name right, Linnea. She's got such amazing vocals, and then the rest of the members are fantastic as well. But Reaching Forward, you know, got this amazing keyboard, incredible, like, incredible dramatic drumming, and then this awesome guitar riff during the verse that I'm just like, it just scratches that itch in my brain, and I'm like, oh, it's incredible, I just love it, it's so good. I'll Be Yours is my favourite track of this album. It's really sweet, it's so wholesome. You can see it as a romantic song, but the music video is very much celebrating the band as like best friends. I remember I made, it's probably cringy, but I was living in Australia at the time and I made my best friend who was in the UK a video using that song to celebrate our friendship. So that song always brings like warm memories to me. And then other songs I really like, Dream About Me, again, it's just got this awesome instrumentation that I love. The whole album is great, you know, it's got great hooks, great sound. I'm just really happy I was able to find this record and that it was pressed on vinyl and everything, because this band is severely underrated. I've not been able to find out much about them because obviously they broke up 10 years ago, but they are truly, truly awesome. Oh, and how can I not talk about Fuckarias? Again, I don't know if I've pronounced that right. I'm not just swearing, it is a track, Fuckarias. Just the perfect angry song, you know? You're getting all the bad energy out and it's great. And again, the drums, incredible. The guitar, you know, just gets more and more intense. And then the keyboard just goes wild in the chorus, and there's some really fast vocal bits and you're just going mental. I love it. But yeah, overall, I adore this album. I'm very, very happy that I have it. cool artwork as well. The next album I got, I picked it up at Dig Vinyl in Liverpool, and I wasn't intending to buy it. I just, this album is quite rare on vinyl. You don't see it every day you walk into a shop. But I got House of Balloons by The Weeknd. I do like The Weeknd. I've got Starboy, his voice is brilliant. I think he's one of the most talented artists of this generation. And my favourite song by The Weeknd is House of Balloons. I mean, I know the actual song track is House of Balloons / Glass Table Girls, but the House of Balloons part of that song is my favourite thing that The Weeknd's done. And the fact, and when I saw this, I was just like, you know what, I've got to get it. I need to get it because I adore the song House of Balloons so much. Like that sample of Happy House by Susie and the Banshees, like the way he uses it, it's incredible. I love the chorus on it. I love the verses he's done for it. It's just, I mean, 2017, when I first heard that song, I played it on repeat all the time. So I had to get this album. And then other songs I really like from House of Balloons is, obviously there's quite some iconic tracks on here. So High For This and Wicked Games, they're quite well known. And yeah, even though I'm not fully familiar with this whole album, you know, there are some tracks that I don't know very well. I'm glad that I have this because, you know, again, it's not very common. And it's nice to have like one of his earlier albums. So yeah. It's funny because the next record I'm gonna show you has quite a few coincidences with the previous record I just showed you, because I also got this record from Dig Vinyl, and this record is Pale Shelter by Tears for Fears. And what's funny is the reason that I discovered Pale Shelter is because on my other Weeknd album, Starboy, I love the song Secrets, and I love the guitar in it, and like the break in the song where it's you know, it's just a vocal, it's someone vocalizing and the guitar's just doing like some awesome chords, and then it kicks back into the song. And I was like, I love that bit so much, it's my favorite bit. And I didn't realize that Secrets samples Pale Shelter. And Tears for Fears are great, like Everybody Wants to Rule the World is one of my favorite songs ever. So when I listened to Pale Shelter, I was like, oh my god, this is amazing. I love it. I'm so glad that The Weeknd led me back to Tears for Fears. But yeah, I was in Dig Vinyl the other day, found this just there with all the other records, and I was like, oh my god, Pale Shelter, I need to get it like right now. What I also love is that this 45 is blue, which is really, really cool. I don't have many colour 45s. But I think this is the only colour 45 I have that is from the time. So it's not like a reissue or something. This is from the 80s and I think that is awesome. But yeah, my favourite things about Pale Shelter is, again, my favourite things from Secrets. I love how bright like the acoustic guitar sounds here. It's just gorgeous. You know, those iconic 80s sounding synths are just perfect. It's just an amazing track and I love it. And then the verses are great too. Like there's no faults. It's perfect. I love it. Another record I've gotten my hands on is Love Will Tear Us Apart by Joy Division. I got this at 81 Renshaw in Liverpool. That record shop is so cool because not only is it a record shop, but they also serve coffee, they do gigs. It just seems like such a cool place to hang out. But yeah, I will be honest, whilst I've been in Liverpool, each time I've gone into a record shop, I have been looking for Love Will Tear Us Apart. Because whilst I wouldn't say I'm like a Joy Division fan, this song has grown on me a lot throughout the past like
18 months. I think I just really love like the synth line. I love just like the chorus, love, love will tear us apart again. Just that whole bit, and then the guitars at the beginning, you know, they sound so bright and lush and lovely. This is a record that I've just wanted to find whenever it's popped up, and thankfully it did pop up. And yeah, the sleeve is really cool. Got These Days on the other side. And yeah, very happy to have gotten my hands on that. Another record I've picked up from HMV is MGMT's Oracular Spectacular. This is an album that my dad used to play on CD. And I remember it would always be like he'd pick me up from school, because normally my mum always picked me up, but I'd have the rare time where my dad was off and he was able to pick me up. And he'd always have this CD like just lying around in his car. And he would normally play Time to Pretend and Kids and Electric Feel, those three, which I think were like the biggest songs from this album. And in the past year, I've become increasingly more into like this genre of music. Like I like to think of this as like indie electronic pop. And I'm really sorry if I've offended people, if I've gotten the wrong genre, but to me it's like indie electronic pop. So whilst I have been massively enjoying Foster the People and Tame Impala recently, MGMT is another band that fits into that little area of music that's just been scratching my brain. But yeah, and also I absolutely adore the cover art. Like this is a vibe right here that I just want to be a part of so badly. Makes me think of summer. I wish it was summer so much right now. I wish I always lived in summer, but I sadly don't. Yeah, I got it. I really enjoyed playing it. Again, the singles, Time to Pretend, Electric Feel, and Kids are everything I love. I just love the sound of them so much, especially Time to Pretend. Time to Pretend is my favorite track from this album. I just love like the really loud and booming synths. It's just so cool. And like, it's just got such a carefree mood and I'm so here for it. Other tracks that I'm not too familiar with, but I definitely will go back to, was Of Moons, Birds and Monsters, and The Handshake from Side 2. So I will definitely go back to those. Again, don't really remember what they sound like right now, but I remember enjoying them whilst they were playing.
And lastly, I've got Beauty and the Beast by David Bowie on a picture disc 45. I got this from the David Bowie pop-up shop in Heddon Street, that's in London right now. If you didn't know, Heddon Street is the place where the album cover for Ziggy Stardust was taken. So to celebrate what would have been David Bowie's 75th birthday next year, there's pop-up shops in Heddon Street as well as New York. I was down in London the other week and I just had to go into the pop-up shop, otherwise I wouldn't get a chance to go in. So I went in and it was really, really cool. You know, they had like a phone booth like the album cover does, and you could go in, dial a number, and it'll be like an audio recording of David Bowie like answering questions. You went downstairs and there was like a 360 8D audio of his songs. You could sit down and like the songs are just like swirling around you, it sounds like. There was vinyl, there was t-shirts, you know, it was merch, it was like jewelry and stuff. It was really cool and I'm really glad I went. And even though I have Beauty and the Beast on Heroes, I didn't buy it for Beauty and the Beast. I actually bought this for its B-side, which is a live version of Blackout. I love Blackout, I especially love live versions of Blackout. My favourite live versions of the song are actually On Stage and Welcome to the Blackout, those two live albums. However, I just wanted the song on its own. I didn't want to buy those albums, because I still can't decide which version I like more. And I know that Welcome to the Blackout is harder to get on vinyl than Stage, but I didn't want to commit to either album. So I just bought this one, because even though it's a little bit different, it's definitely a slower rendition of the song. I still love to hear the song live, so I'm glad I've got it. And the picture looks really cool. But yeah, so those are all the records I've gotten recently. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in another video. Bye guys.